Hello, everyone. I'm grateful to be with you today and to talk with you about one of my favorite subjects, citrus oils. Now, I know you probably know a lot about citrus oils, and if you're like me, you use them all the time. You can't come to my office without me diffusing citrus oils. You can't go to my home without me diffusing citrus oils. We use them in a lot of different ways, personally and within our home. And so you're probably the same way with citrus oils, and then you already know that citrus oils have a lot of common and similar properties. In doTERRA, we have a lot of different citrus oils. We have lemon, we have bergamot, we have lime, we have grapefruit, we have pink grapefruit, we have wild orange, we have tangerine. And I have asked myself the question many times, why do we need so many citrus oils? Well, the answer lies in some of the things that we'll discuss. So even though they have some similar properties, for example, we all have individual preference associated with the citrus oils. Some may like lemon and some may like wild orange. It doesn't matter. They have shared benefits. And the benefits that we see is primarily coming because of the limonene that citrus oils contain. Now, some have more limonene than others. For example, when we look at grapefruit, wild orange, and tangerine, they all have 95% or more of pure D-limonene. And we like limonene, and that's primarily what we talk about with citrus oils, because limonene has very broad benefits within the body. For example, it's really good for supporting digestion. A lot of times when people have stomach upset, one of the ways that I like to create that soothing comfort that we're looking for is by taking a citrus oil, putting a few drops in water or taking it within a capsule. It supports healthy metabolism. There's even been a lot of studies talking about how limonene can help to sustain normal levels of healthy cholesterol. So we all are familiar with the benefits of essential oils in the citrus category. We talk about using them consistently and making them a part of your daily routine. Well, I want to introduce a new citrus oil to you today. And you're familiar with this oil because it comes right from Brazil, and that is green mandarin. Now, there's some unique features associated with green mandarin that personally I really, really like. One is that it has some unusual chemistry. It does have limonene, but limonene is not its only compound. And the compound that it has in addition to limonene, gamma terpenine, is actually very unusual and different. It has a non-typical aroma. And then the other thing that's unique about green mandarin is that it's green mandarin, meaning that it's the unripened red mandarin fruit. And the difference between the red mandarin and the green mandarin is subtle, but it's very unique and it gives us a completely different profile. One of the most notable things that we see is that with green mandarin, we don't have any photosensitivity, and that's because furocoumarins have not yet developed within the chemistry of the green mandarin or the unripened fruit. Now, there's a whole co-impact sourcing that goes along with green mandarin, talking about how typically this is a throwaway, but in doTERRA, having seen the value associated with the essential oil, we now give them opportunity to be able to use this very differently. And green mandarin is powerful because of the limonene and also the amount of gamma terpenine that it has associated with it. So let's talk about maybe some of the typical uses that we can use, that we can have with green mandarin. Now, I'll give you a reminder that you can use it the same way you'll use all of the other citrus oils, but it has some unique features because of that chemistry. For example, limonene and the gamma terpenine, they work together and it decreases neuronal excitability. Now, if you don't know what I'm referring to when I say neuronal excitability, we can have excitability neurologically in several different ways. One of the primary ways that we see that is when we have some type of a disruption within tissue. We're uncomfortable or we have a little bit of discomfort. This is an essential oil, keeping in mind again, no furocoumarins, that we can apply topically and it can be soothing to those tissues. Now, another thing that I thought was really interesting is that when we look at things like that, we always want to have healthy, normalized inflammatory responses within the body. And this is just one example. I'm talking about the five LOX pathway associated here, and that's primarily associated with the respiratory system. Most citrus oils are very supportive of the respiratory system. Green mandarin is no exception, and primarily because of its disruption within this pathway, we can help to normalize, have healthy responses to the body in inflammatory circumstances. And so that's what we're looking for, not just within this pathway, but sustains that and helps to create that normalcy and support the body and its ability to do so in many different systems of the body. Now, it has other applications too. Just like other citrus oils, we can diffuse green mandarin. It's uplifting and it's elevating to the mood. I like combining it with lime and eucalyptus. Now, you can use the eucalyptus radiata, or you can use your other favorite oils that you might have, but lime and eucalyptus are wonderful essential oils to combine this with for respiratory support. We can apply it topically to directly to the tissues to calm irritation, to soothe the tissues. If you're going to do that, I always recommend that you dilute, not because the oil itself is going to be irritating, but because we want to localize the response and the benefit that you're receiving. You can do one or two drops in a capsule, and that'll give you good cell support throughout the body. Combining that with frankincense is a good thing to do, or combining green mandarin with yarrow palm is another great way to create good, healthy metabolic support. Green mandarin fast became one of my very favorite essential oils. I hope you enjoy it as much as I have. I hope to see you all very soon. Thanks for spending just a few minutes with me.
Quando criamos a doTERRA, uma das coisas mais importantes para nós era a transparência desde o início. Então, trabalhar com estes pequenos produtores, ver o amor que eles têm por seu trabalho, o amor que têm uns pelos outros em suas comunidades e como apoiam-se mutuamente, é uma experiência incrível.
Uma das coisas que mais gosto neste óleo é naturalmente o aroma. É diferente de todos os outros óleos cítricos. A mandarina verde é singular porque não é fotossensível. Isso significa que posso ter o aroma fresco comigo, mesmo quando estou num ambiente aberto, no meio do dia, com toda essa luz do sol. Esta é uma vantagem única associada a este óleo. Ele é energizante, mas também alivia e acalma o corpo. Isso é um pouco da diversidade que vemos em sua química.
Minha família vem produzindo óleos essenciais cítricos há muito tempo. Eu sou a quarta geração. Meu bisavô começou a produzir óleos essenciais cítricos em 1873. Qualidade é muitíssimo importante para nós. Somos muito orgulhosos por produzir os melhores óleos essenciais possíveis.
Quando falamos da mandarina verde, falamos da fruta não madura. Ela passa por um processo de afinamento onde são removidos 70% da fruta verde. Então, os 30% restantes podem amadurecer e serem extraídos e vendidos posteriormente no mercado de frutas. Normalmente, os 70% que são afinados seriam um produto desperdiçado. Mas, como há uma necessidade de óleo essencial de mandarina verde, agora paga-se um ótimo preço por isso. Que jeito maravilhoso de ser compensado durante todo o processo. E nós somos os beneficiários, porque podemos desfrutar deste incrível óleo essencial pressionado a frio.